छोटे से दुनिया का बड़ा सा इंडिया, यह है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। चाय का प्याला हो या गपशप मिर्च मसाला हो, पैशन है, अग्रेशन है, बिन बात का पैशन है, स्टार्टअप गिरी का फितूर है, अरे तभी तो इंडिया मशहूर है। उम्मीद का सवेरा है, खुशियों का बसेरा है, सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, यह है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। मिट्टी में जो हम सपने बोते हैं वो आसमान को छूते हैं, गुडलक की टोपी पहन के भी शीश हमारे झुक जाते हैं। यहां जीत की होती तंग गलियों में तैयारी है और कागज की कश्तियां भी करती किनारों की सवारी है। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। यहां आईना है, तस्वीरें हैं, संस्कृति भी खास है, चमकते बाजारों में मुस्कुराता प्यार है, रंग बिरंगी पोशाकों में तभी तो लगते चांद चार है, खुशियां हैं बिहारों की, मिलजुल की बहारों की। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। पतंगों के मेलों में कटती रंजिशों की डोर है, सैर है, सपाटे हैं, यहां टूरिस्ट बड़े आते हैं। ये मेरा है, ये तेरा है, पोषों का सवेरा है, धूप है, छांव है, उन्नति के गांव है। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। पैगामों का इंडिया, हाजिर जवाबों का इंडिया, गुब्बारों में उड़ते आसमानों का इंडिया, कश्ती में सवार निकल पड़ा है इंडिया, पंख फैलाए उड़ चला है इंडिया। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, छोटी सी दुनिया का बड़ा सा इंडिया, यह है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया।
Thank you so much, Dheeraj, for a lovely motivational video which explain how Franchise India is creating opportunity for all our investors or all our brands. It's been more than 20 years we are giving and helping our brands and potential business buyers to get business and other things from us. With this welcome note, we welcome you to the 35th edition of Business Opportunity of a Chai, a webinar series which provide again investment and franchise opportunity for each one of us. In our panel, we have Gaurav Maurya, who is the chairman, Franchise India Group, and our MD, Sonia Ma'am, for this particular session. And as usual, they'd be sharing their insights, views, and thoughts on industry as well as on brand. We welcome today's brand of the day. We have Magnify, and it's our opportunity that we have Vikram, who is a co-founder and CPO, and Kiran, directly interacting with each one of us and talking about how they are creating value in market and what opportunity they are offering to all our investors. With this, I welcome formally the team of Magnify. But before that, we would like to play a small video for each one of us. Over to you, Dheeraj, for a playing. Thank you so much for the video. Now over to you, Vikram and Kiran, to take it further. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Archana. Good morning, everyone. First of all, thank you for Gaurav and Sonia and to the franchisee group for giving an opportunity for us to present about our product or a big platform and talk about what is that we are bringing to the retail industry. So I welcome you all to the Minify, an online to offline social commerce marketplace platform. So we launched this product in February 2020. So before we get into the product, let's try to understand a small glance about our retail industry. So retail industry in India is very huge. It's one of the big major industries, which constitutes to 10% of total GDP share with over 50 lakh crores of market value. That's very huge industry. So the market size is very high. It's over 4-5 crore shops, the physical shops available. And out of that, 10% is operating in online nature, and still 90% are in offline nature. That means there should be some strong reason in these digital times why this 90% still exists. So the market environment is now we are building 100+ smart cities, and we already have 4,000+ tier 2 and tier 3 cities in India. So this is a little bit background about the retail industry in India. So now let's try to understand the offline nature of the business retail industry and try to see what could be the real challenges for the two types of users in retail, which is offline buyers and offline sellers. So now suppose somebody who has decided to do only offline shopping. So now in these difficult times with hari-bari nature, very difficult to find time. So one has to spend time in identifying the seller, because most of the times what happens is we need something, but we don't know which seller has the product available with them right now. So to identify that, we end up in visiting multiple stores, and we go to each store and ask for that product and find out if they have it or not. Even though they have it, this is a tendency in nature, right? We don't finalize at one seller place. We want to visit multiple stores to check if any other better seller is offering for a better price or offers something like that. So this is a tedious process nowadays, because somebody has to wait for a weekend to do this, or because we are all busy in our lives, and this has become one of the tedious problem in a day-to-day life for every offline buyer. So what could be the primary reason for an offline buyer to do offline shopping only when we have e-commerce going at faster, rapid pace, where a product is delivered to their doorstep? So probably one primary reason we could think of is the touch and feel experience, validating the product and the seller physically. So that is not there on e-commerce. Probably that may be the main reason why they want to do offline shopping, to do the touch and feel experience. So now coming to the sellers. So if it is so huge, these are so, e-commerce is so huge, and everybody in to the tier 2 and tier 3 cities aware of all the big giants, how they are bringing customer base to them, and why these are not available on these portals. There should be some strong reason for them. So what according to us in our research, we could identify was, for these lot of these used sellers, catalog maintenance, product maintenance is a very big task, and it is very complex for them to do. Sometimes the ability is not there, or the time, because they're already handling all these activities in the offline. So they don't want to disturb their offline nature, but online visibility is very important for them. They need that online visibility, yet operate in the traditional manner. That is something they want to know. So by understanding this, we designed this solution, which is Minify, aiming at minimizing the efforts of buyers and sellers, an online to offline social commerce marketplace platform. Now let's see how this works. It's a very simple to use app, mobile based and web based app, wherein a buyer can create in the form of an individual order or a social commerce, or form a group of people and create order. While creating orders, that they can mention what is that they are looking at. If suppose they have a picture of it, they can upload that picture. they have a reference link, they can add that reference link and or mention the product details. Now this order is visible to these sellers. The left side is the buyer screen, the right side on that is the seller screen. So seller would see who are registered on this platform under that category and location. If they are matching that, they would be able to see this order, buyer name, what is it they are requesting for, the image if they have added, the link if they have they given to it. Now they have to do simple one click of a button, click on quote and give their price if they have that product with them and give them offers if they are running any offers on that product. Now you are, as a buyer, now you are sitting at home and getting information from all your local neighborhood sellers in the location which you have, you are okay to visit. Now you are deciding the best seller at home or identifying the seller who has the product with them right now. And you are simply visiting and talking and telling them that, okay, boss, I am coming. I have liked your quote. Now I accepted your quote and I'll come at so and so time and I'll visit your shop and do the touch and feel. I'm not foregoing my touch and feel experience. I'll validate my seller, validate the product by looking at it physically and then complete the shopping at this seller's site. This way, this is the order feature for individual order. Now what we are saying is, we are introducing, we are also adding social commerce to it, because social commerce is not a new thing, but earlier, since it was an online payment where you had to rely only on forming a group with your known people, because one has to pay on behalf of others for the quantity of high number and then get back that money from others. But here what we are saying is, since the purchase is happening at offsite, offline at the store, so you can form a group with utmost strangers in your location. Because at the same time, suppose you take a mobile phone, at the same time, the mobile phone requirement is not only for you in your area or a location. There might be 10 other people who might want to buy the same product. So why don't you form a group? And naturally, the bargaining power is high because the quantity is increased to 10, which is a good opportunity for a retailer to sell the quantity in 10 at a time. And there is a high tendency that a seller might give a better discount, which is getting translated to the group of buyers. And all the group will visit the store at a time or at their convenience based on the discussion they have with their seller and buy them at an individual level. So that means you're forming a group, you are able to negotiate better. So that's about order feature. So another feature we have is the local shop sales and offers. So since the platform is online to offline, so what we are saying is you can sit at home and run through or browse through the local sales or local offers. It can be a product offer, it can be a sale offer. Suppose we see that all the brands, retailers want to publish their offers or anything like lifestyle you take, they want to publish their monsoon sale, something like that. Now they rely on Flipboards, they rely on Metro Pillars, they rely on paper ads. That is already there, but this is a new platform where somebody can see all the local area offers, what offers they are running, which suppose if it is an apparel shopping, somebody is planning to do an apparel shopping. So without stepping out, I can browse and set the filter criteria that in my location for apparel, what are the offers, which stores offers are running. Now I'm able to plan my shopping in a better way and I can minimize my shopping efforts. If somebody, I may prioritize to which shop I should visit first, then next shop, which store I should visit first, something like that. So that way, we are minimizing the efforts of a buyer and a seller for a seller to reach to more customers through an online medium. And for a buyer, we are minimizing their efforts in identifying the best seller without stepping out from their house. So I think these were the benefits which I spoke and while talking about the product. So social commerce, it's a win-win opportunity for both buyer and seller because the quantity forming with the group is high. And for a seller through a order creation, he's able to identify the store who has the product at the right time on that moment. And for a seller, he can go online instantly because there is no catalog management. They need not upload any of their products onto this platform. They simply need to respond to the order which is created by click of a button. Now they can customize offers dynamically, which is a new, see, suppose some a new order is very interesting with a high quantity, and every day is a new day in retail industry, because every hour is a new hour sometimes for a same retailer. Sometimes the desperation level goes very high, and he want to convert any kind of lead into their customer, into their buyer. That time they can customize the offer on the spot to the order of the nature, and assign this order offer only to that specific order. So suppose here in this platform, you need not publish. You can publish a public offer which is visible to everyone, but at the same time you also have spot offers where you can create a customizable offer only to that specific order, which is not visible to anyone else. That way, sellers can create a flexible mode in getting or converting the leads which we are showing on the platform into their customers. It depends on how they want to do the business, or how creatively, innovatively they want to attract and pull these online customers into their shop. So single canvas for every product category. If it's an order, it is specific to most of the categories, but if it is a public offer, every possible category is applicable here, because it's just a publishing the offer or the sale. It can be apparel, it can be restaurant, it can be food joint, it can be beverages. Anybody can publish their offer, sales, which they want, however they want to pull the customers to their joints, physical joints. So revenue model is very simple. What we are saying is, for a seller, it's pay as you use. That means it's free to be on the portal. It's free to see the orders. Now you want to participate in the game, then you have to have points in your bucket and utilize those points to participate in the game. Now you want to publish offers, as a certain amount of points will be deducted based on the category, subcategory, or number of branches you have. Based on there is a simple calculation done there, and it will be shown to you while you are publishing an offer. Similarly, when you want to quote, it will be mentioned there for the what kind of category, how many points will be deducted while you are quoting to the order. Here you are also giving re-quotation option, where somebody, the desperation is so high and you want to convert. First time they might have given for 10,000 rupees, but he is waiting for some more time. After 1 hour, is still the order, the acceptance here has not come to the seller, but he still want to further give away some bargain, and he want to reduce his price to 9,500. So here he can do on the fly and say, he can re-quote again and say, now I want to give it for 9,500, you can please come and pick it. So that re-quotation option is also given to the seller. So this is estimated revenue for this portal. Since the market size, we have seen that it's above 4 or 5 crore sellers. Even if you're targeting 10% of market share in 5 years, and if the monthly spending power by each seller is 1,000 rupees, that's very, very minimum, I guess, because 1,000 rupees in a month is very, very nominal for every seller. You want to do a simple branding activity, it is like 10,000 rupees is minimum, bare minimum. So now at 1,000 rupees, if we take, if we go with a single seller is spending 1,000 rupees per month, so 6-7 crores for 10% market share is the revenue can be generated. If it is like 5 lakh sellers, like 1% of market share, probably 600 crores. So it goes with the number of sellers onboarded onto the platform. The competition analysis, we do little competition analysis, how different we are with the existing e-commerce portals. So group buying, that is done in a different way, because you just need to have purchase with high quantity and distribute among ourselves. But here you need not buy in quantity, you just need to form the group and you will buy individually. So that's the difference here. The quotation or price showcase, yes, it's there in both the cases, but dynamic re-quotation is not there, because dynamically you cannot change the price. Once the order is placed, you cannot change the price in the existing e-commerce portals, wherein even you are participating in the game, you can re as many times as you want, you can re-quote until the timer is available in the order. So customizable offers, which I spoken earlier, that a seller can customize the offer to a specific order dynamically on the spot and give it to that order. And the touch and feel shopping experience is what is restored, which is a primary aspect why we feel that why there is so huge offline shopping still exists in India, with, even though in this digital time. And product showcasing is the primary issue for these offline sellers not going to online portals is what we consider is the main big pain point. That's why these guys won't join these portals, because that demands them to give a lot of time to maintain that portal, which they already do in the offline. They already do that inventory management. They already do that showcasing in the offline store. Again, they are, if you ask them to do it, the same activity on the online store, which is a tedious process, and they need some team to do that, which is a costly affair for them. So this is our team. Krishna, this is our experience of the team. We four are co-founders. Krishna handles the company operations and HR activities, delivery part of the product. I am the product chief product officer, and I handle the finance related operations. Kiran handles the marketing and franchisee operations. Naveen is our technology guy. So we are all of us has over a decade of years of experience in corporate industry. We come from we have prior experience with MNCs, and we before we started this organization. So these are the few press features where we were about featured recently. They were talking about how this product can be useful in these Corona COVID-19 times and minimize outside exposure, because we are cutting down their outside spending time by identifying the right seller sitting at home without visiting multiple shops. That means you're limiting your exposure to outside. You are planning your shopping and talking to your seller and telling them that you can come at so and so time and pick it up. And your offline seller also can avoid multiple floating people who simply come to inquire about products. So this is implemented across India properly. So coming to the franchisee options, that was about the product and the benefits and the platform for the retailers and buyers. So what we are, as I said, the market is so huge, it's above 5 crore people. So it is very difficult. We need that sales force as well to get on all of them onboarded onto this platform. So what we thought, we will issue this platform franchisee, wherein a unit franchisee, somebody is interested to take this unit franchisee, they are allowed to get 1,000 sellers onboarded onto this platform. And all those sellers, revenue which is generated by them, 10% of revenue will be shared with them on a monthly basis. Suppose we decided that, we thought that, we estimated that 1,000 rupees per seller is the bare minimum a seller can spend on this platform. So if that 1,000 is spent by every seller on a monthly basis, for 1,000 sellers, 10% commission revenue will be up to 1 lakh a month. That too for a total investment of 3 lakhs. Out of that, 2 lakhs is just a franchisee fee, and 3 lakhs, an extra lakh is for you to have your team to get field representatives who will be onboarding these sellers on behalf of you, or if you want to do by yourself, even you can cut down that a lakh also. So this is a 3-year term period, and it will be renewed after every 3 years. So the responsibilities of a unit franchisee person would be to onboard these 1,000 sellers onto the platform, be the single point of contact to these sellers, motivate them to use the apps or communicate new features to the sellers, or any other activities which we ask you to do to these 1,000 sellers. You will be given a platform portal wherein you will be able to see the engagement of these sellers, what are the sellers you have, what are their contact numbers, what kind of business they are doing, what is the commission you are getting on a monthly basis. All this information will be available in the portal. So once you sign up with us, you'll be given that portal and you'll be able to see how things are going in the portal. So we have state-wise master franchisee options, pan-India master franchisee options. Since every state is different, the dynamics are different, we cannot have a uniform model for every state. because the population, or it can be the dynamics or the demographics, are different for every state. So we can get into one-on-one discussions based on the interest of the state or the region where you are interested in. Then based on that, we can decide on a franchise model, how you want to take it up. That can be done on a one-on-one. If somebody is interested, they can get in touch with the franchise team or us. So we can work out on that model. So we are also issuing preferential shares, which can be convertible or cumulative redeemable.
You can go on a back slide.
Yeah, I'm going back. Yeah. So with a face value of 100 per share, so we are looking at a minimum share purchase is 5,000. That means 5 lakh investment. Maximum shares we are issuing is 2 crore baht. So every year, if somebody is not aware of what is a preferential share, so it's a preferential share over equity shareholder, wherein a dividend will be declared on every year based on the company's growth, and that dividend will be given to that shareholder based on the value of the shares you hold. And tomorrow you can participate, and the growth value will increase as per the growth of the company is there. So that's a little bit information about preferential share, and you can do more, you can find out more information, what are the different types of preferential shares available in an organization. Yeah, I think I am done from my side, and I am open to any questions somebody has.
So thank you Vikram, very insightful, and I congratulate all the four founders in terms of creating this a platform. You know, the last 4 or 5 months I've been doing a lot of demos and a lot of you know, user experience on the platform. So I think it is a great technology bridge you are trying to create, and I would like in the next 10 minutes going deeper into the business model, because whenever we got platforms coming through, we would like to understand that. Because the platforms are great because they create some solution, they create some answer, some problem, you know, and they always designed to address a big problem. And that's what technology does. Technology helps you to address some problem. And then over that problem, which was created, you create a commerce. So first try to get the first question on the business model. What is the problem we're trying to address? While you've explained, we are doing social commerce, we are trying to create group buying. We are trying to do what I call inventory mismanagement, which is there in the market. But what is the big problem we are trying to address here? And we have to really be clear, because are we talking from buyer viewpoint? Are we talking from a seller viewpoint? Who's the bigger problem you want to address? Is it buyer problem or is it seller problem? So over to you. I would like to go deeper into the business model, and then we'll talk layers on that.
Sure. And,
yeah.
Sure. Sure, Gaurav. Yeah, definitely it's a buyer problem, Gaurav, because buyer is every day, you know, the environment changes, our needs are changing, our problems are changing, our availabilities are changing. So, and the digital times are changing, the technologies are improving. So with these times, we are becoming busy and busy on a day-to-day, and we are not able to give time to many activities. So considering that, definitely it's a buyer problem, but your tendency, your cultural background tells you that you want to do only offline shopping with this, on this context here, with this product nature. So you are bound to do only offline shopping because you want to get the feel of the product by yourself, physically you want to validate the seller or the product. That is the first priority for you, and that's why we have seen, we were doing research for 3 months before we started this product development, and we were visited multiple offline sellers, and we were discussing with these retailers. So we were asking them what is the bigger problem for you also. And we have seen people who were coming to the shops, because we were waiting on the shop's owner, retailers, and we heard people saying that no matter what, I'll wait 10 days, but I'll buy in only offline. We have heard from a couple of people saying this, because they are not, the lot of people don't rely. That's why probably 90% is still huge retail industry exists in India offline. So considering that, buyer is a bigger problem. Buyer's problem is bigger compared to seller. But with these COVID-19, the interruption of supply chains has created issues for the sellers also, because now sellers need some mechanism to pull customers to their shops, because now they are investing lot of money on a monthly basis. They spend on inventory, on the operating capital to maintain the huge buildings or infrastructure, which they need customers to be entering into their stores. They cannot go onto online for the nature or the complexity or the ability they have. So with this, it also becomes important for these sellers also. Yeah, but to your question, I think on a relatable level, buyer is a bigger problem compared to seller.
No, so sure. So I will stay to that question and I will go deeper into that because at this stage and for our audience, we've also launched from today two different opportunities which would come. One is opportunity of franchising, but we also doing now bringing a lot of early stage startups, which you can also look at
in
some kind of equity investment. So a little bit we will go from that perspective also, because when you look at investing into an equity, it's a long-term investment cycle. You are an early stage investor in the company. You need to really see as an investor and to see that you're having the same kind of a mindset and an opportunity. But when it will buy a franchise, you might more from a geographical mindset and say, this geography, would this work? Is it suited to you? And so on and so forth. So at this stage, I think I would like to go a little more deeper into the business model, because a lot of our investors were writing to us that they don't want to invest, buy a franchise but they would still like to invest maybe small money and be part of a company. Yes. So there is an equity play. So let's go back to the business model. And when you said you are addressing a buyer issue, and buyer is always about three things, you know, which we call one, choices. He needs a lot of choices. Second,
sorry, your voice is breaking. Can you please repeat?
Yeah. So the buyer is always looking at three different things. One is choices. It needs more choices. It needs more options.
Yes.
Second, it is always looking at what I call value, which means that, can I get cheaper than market? And today, if I'm discovering on online, I have another window called Amazon. Why would I not go on Amazon and find value? So third is a user experience, and the user experience is how do I empower my user experience? So let's go into deeper on these three things. These are only three things. If you give it to buyer, then you can shift a buyer. Otherwise buyer would not shift. Fundamentally, on the options, it's a chicken and egg, because you are a young company, you're getting started. You don't have so many sellers here. So how soon you will be able to wrap up market by market, geography by geography, because you might be in one neighborhood, you need to wrap up your seller base very high so that you are able to give options to the buyer. Second, what is your answer on the value, how you will compete with a lot of other windows available where there can be option of cheaper product being available, the same product be available cheaper, and why would a customer stay with you? And third, what are you doing for a last mile user experience? These are three questions from my side in terms of the buyer satisfaction.
Yeah. Yes, Gaurav. So first, with respect to the alternatives, when somebody is browsing a lot of portals and doing their own research and identifying where or what kind of different alternatives are available in different portals. So we have added the same feature in this portal, this model as well. A seller can, even though I'm creating an order for particular product or the mobile, let's take example of mobile phone itself, and I'm mentioning my budget saying I am looking for a product in 20,000 budget with so and so specifications. So I'm open to all kinds of options. Now seller also can come back to the same order saying that, see, you're asking for a particular Samsung phone, but we have better alternatives with us, and these are the alternatives we have, and this is the prices for these alternatives. So now you are able to get that same information which you will visit and find out in a store. And then without visiting the store, you are getting this information in a compiled version where you need not jot down. Suppose you are doing the same exercise in a physical manner. Now you will visit one store, you take this information, and now you have to jot down this in some book or remember this in your mind. Now you visit the other one and you again, there's a confusion, okay, who has got what at all. Now we are coming to your user experience. Now we are compiling this entire process of information into small cards in the mobile app or the website where the best options will be showing in ascending or descending order. They'll be able to sort it out and get to know who has given what alternatives, what offers they have given. And you are sitting at home and getting the information of all these offline stores, and you are deciding to which store I will go. And since we have option of adding a reference link to this order, that suppose you want to add a Amazon link that Amazon is person is selling this product for this price. Now, what is the available price for you at offline store? Because I am an offline purchaser. I don't like to purchase online. So I want to purchase only from offline store. So what is that you want to give it to me? So that kind of mechanism is already there here. So that means we have created a platform in such a way that a buyer can get all this information without spending much time outside.
And how soon you will be able to wrap up a neighborhood? Because, you know, I personally feel that you cannot address all markets all the time. Say I become a franchisee in Hyderabad. And how soon you will be able to wrap up? Because you have two major problems. One territorial problem. And second is you have a lot of categories to address. From consumer products to fashion to... So you can go there. And in every single piece, you need to create a lot of choices, you know. Yes. And how do you want to address that? I mean, this is a very big...
Yeah. Yes, Gaurav. That's the biggest challenge for us as a portal owners. So what we planned is we don't want to communicate entire product or categories at once. So we are shortlisting couple of categories like electronics, mobile categories or lifestyle fashion, which is high in demand. The user base is high usually. A lot of buyers would need a lot of every day on a daily basis. This need is high. So we have shortlisted those categories, and we want to take it. For that reason, if we can get the franchisees, merchant subscribers, and we want to limit to a zone, first take Hyderabad and do digital marketing only in Hyderabad area, and the offline people who are visiting this merchant subscribing process who will be getting onboarding these sellers. So accordingly, we want to take one by one. And suppose if we get that right, because this is a marketing is the biggest major aspect which is needed for this product to communicate to across India. So if we cannot take it at the same time until unless we have that kind of budget, if we want to promote at a time in across India, pan India. So probably we want to, suppose if somebody is interested in master franchises and they are coming on board, so we'll talk with them what would be their capacity, how they want to work with us, what kind of value add they want to bring to the table. See, we are calling them franchisee partners. So they have to work in conjunction with the idea of what we have. It's not just that they take the portal to them and they work on their own. No, we have to decide a plan together. So we have we'll be working with the digital team in conjunction with the offline plan they are doing. So region wise we have to take. Then we can only achieve synergy or create some engagement on the portal. Yeah, but this is a real challenge, Gaurav, and we have to live with that. There is no other option.
Okay, I'll have one more question and then I pass it to Sonia, because I think she has a lot of questions for you. Raising money, and which is very important for any startup and for our audience, a lot of people are writing, but there is no problem in accepting that they are early stage startup and a franchise is way of creating their distribution, and one should be very honest. Reaching out and So they're bringing some disruption technology, and they need partners which invest very small and become their partner and develop the territory. It can also be an opportunity for somebody to take complete state and develop that state, and they bring the technology. The partner brings in capability of a ground, because India runs on neighborhoods and runs on regions. So I take, say, Kerala. I can own complete Kerala market and the whole consumption in Kerala market and distribute the technology. Even the technology can be customized in different languages, and couple of other parts of the app can be in the local language, and so the whole business model can go multifold.
Yes, right. Absolutely right.
And that's why they're raising money also. So they would raise from both institutional investors and retail investors. This time we're talking about retail investors. Retail investors, if they invest with the company now, they can be part of the initial investment cycle. So they get a very fair valuation, which they have put in a 100 rupees par value. And you have a right of even an exit at a time where they do a sophisticated round, which means that they go on a Series A or any other raise which happens. So the investors can find exit out of that. But that's a call which has to be taken with a lot of... at both sides, I would advise that they need to take a lot of legal and commercial opinion before they make any investment. Now, my question is that if you want to raise money, one, what is the size of immediate raise you want to do? Second, where is the deployment of money going in? Is it technology, marketing, capability development? Where are you deploying the money?
Yeah, so we are looking somewhere around 2 crores to 5 crores for one region, which is AP and Telangana probably, because since we are from Hyderabad, so we can target these regions because of the language, common language we have. So we can rely on YouTube channels, influencer reviewers, because we have seen the progress when we did with one of the YouTube reviewer, and we saw a lot of above 500 plus registrations done on the fly within one day's time. So we saw that good response while doing YouTube channels for digital medium. And we will deploy merchant subscribers the way we have for Paytm or all other merchant subscribers. We already started that activity a couple of days back, and we are seeing some registrations happening on the portal. So we hardly did any marketing campaigns, but we have around 600 odd orders created on the portal. Buyers are testing, so they are coming across the product. They are testing by creating the orders, and they are canceling. Some are waiting for the responses. Some even got responses from the sellers also. A couple of them, not many, but as I said, we just launched this product in February, and immediately we went into lockdown mode for a couple of months, and we just opened. Market is opened only weeks back. So we couldn't do anything there. So now that market is open and it is for the offline market, so we just started with our activities. And if we have good investments, so 60 to 70% goes in the marketing only, Gaurav. 30-40% we need for infrastructure, the resources, or the team activities or operation capital. So that's the beauty of this platform, Gaurav, in compared to any other e-commerce. Here, there are no other operating capital overheads, like no need to have your own inventory, no need to have logistics collaboration, no packaging, all that. Because this is just an aggregator platform where we are creating a medium for a seller and a buyer. Shopping is done offline. And we are very clear that we don't want to lead these sellers. They're all small retailers who don't, and that's the reason we are not charging them percentage on the sale. Rather, they will be happy. Even if you ask them 1%, they'll say, sorry, I'll not use your platform. Or instead, you say, you pay me a subscription based as per your need, then utilize this platform as per your need. Then they'll be very happy to use. Once this platform is created, there are so many other business models can be created on this platform. You can do a lot of other collaborations. You can analytics driven market and revenue models can be created. So there are other ways to generate money on this platform instead of leading the seller. They are all small time retailers. They are the owners of the store. They open the store, they close the store. and they sit on the table, they'll have one or two helpers. Then if you ask them 10% or 5% on the margin of what they are getting, they'll say, sorry boss, I am not interested to be on the platform. So we had this thought, and purposefully we said we don't want to have lead them. So let's create a healthy environment platform offers of offline buyers and sellers. Then we can have multiple revenue models created on the platform. Yeah, it's a 10-year or 5-year plan where, 1 crore every day transaction happens. Now I need not tell anyone. So there are multiple models can be created if one and on a daily basis 1 crore transaction happens. Right? So that's the capacity of the product across India.
I agree with you. Concentrate on the buyer. Concentrate complete energy on buyer. And initial days, you don't have the other side completely available. The seller side is fragmented at this moment for you. You need to do assisted buying. Assisted buying means that if I'm a buyer identified, if I need a, say, XYZ product, your team should go and assistance to really go reach out to create another buyer group to create that last mile user experience. This might continue to the time. It becomes an automated process that a buyer and a seller can find. And we have seen in a lot of other technology companies which came early days, they created a lot of frustration because you would have one demand not being fulfilled and people to stop coming to your platforms. But if I find a buyer that he's interested in buying a fridge and I go out and talk to 10, 20, 30 people, try to get him an offer, try to fulfill his facilitation, get him a better space. I would like to invite now Sonia. Sonia, your remarks and a lot of questions which you have in mind, please go ahead.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Vikram and Kiran, coming together on this webinar and putting this great presentation together. I would say in the last many webinars and opportunities that we've got across to our investors, this is the first of its kind, and hence we have inquiries which are unique to many other inquiries that we received from the past. So a little bit more on, you know, how the business model works, which we would come to. I like to put my own perspective, and perhaps you can add on to that. So there are two aspects. One is O2O, and the other is the social commerce, which people need a little bit of more understanding. But I'll put my own insights on it, and maybe you can add on to it or correct to whatever I say. So overall, I feel the O2 opportunity has evolved in the last few years because of growth of technology, which is one big reason. And today, consumers are looking at omni-channel experience, so to say. They want to go to all channels. They want to go to Amazon, and they want to go to O2 and find out between the organized players and also the unorganized ones where they get the best rates out of. Unlike the limitation that we had in the past, where people were only researching online, they were purchasing offline, which is the ROPO thing. So, and that was not adding any kind of value. So you were exploring or discovering somewhere else, and you were buying somewhere else. An O2O platform, I would say, is not a competition as far as my understanding goes. Yes. Rather, it is it complements the existing platforms like the other organized marketplaces that we have. It creates a link between the two. Yeah. And also, I feel there's a growth because overall, the penetration of mobiles in the market, and today India has over 630 odd million users, more than that, which are currently using mobiles. So digital literacy on both ends, I would say, consumer end, and also at the side of the unorganized retailers, which for us is a bigger opportunity because most of the organized players are already online or working with the top two or two players. And mobility restriction, which you also talked about, because a lot of people today don't want to go out, which can be self-imposed or otherwise because of any regulations which come in. People want to restrict their movement outside their homes or workplaces. Yeah. They would move on to O2 and explore which are the options available in their neighborhood. And also, I would say there's a big demand for a convenience, where people want to have convenience and being hyper-local for any brand or a platform like you will be the bigger differentiator for a buyer because he wants to look at opportunities and maybe shops which are very close to him. So, and we talked about a lot of categories. I saw a whole list of, I think there were 25 what categories we talked about. And I maybe like to add, and that is also for a lot of people there. There are a lot of people who want to buy online. There are people who want to buy offline. But there are many people who want to discover online while they want to buy offline because there are certain products which might be high on value, especially electronics. jewelry is one item where people explore online, but they come and buy offline. And also maybe touch and feel factors where products like cosmetics and sometimes apparel where you actually go and try, not in these times, but that's how it has been. So which makes relevant, the O2O space. And social commerce for a lot of our people who want to understand is a platform where people in that neighborhood can come together. They can even form a group on the app, if I'm not wrong. And they can together place a combined demand. So if I have, say, 10 people wanting to buy a mobile or a certain category of product or electronic, whatever that may be, I can reach out and I can perhaps as a consumer, I can get a discounted price from the retailer.
Sonia, I just want to give you an example over here. When we are talking about mobiles, it's a smaller amount. Say, for example, if a customer wants to purchase a flat, which will nothing cost less than 50 lakhs. Okay, if 10 people form a group, and if the builder is giving a discount of 500 per SFT also, okay, on a 1000 SFT flat, each customer will be getting a discount of 5 lakh rupees. And they have formed a group. And for the builder as well, it's a big advantage. I mean, like all the 10 flats getting booked at a time. So that's the impact it makes on social commerce, Sonia.
Great. I think that's one thing which, I don't know, Amazon, other players are not doing that. One question I had, from the presentation which I was going through, I have a question on if there are any available stats on people buying online versus O2O. While O2O is still, coming up, and I understand the statistics and number of users coming on these platforms comparatively would be low, but how do you see this market growing versus online? And while you're a bridge between, you don't compete with them, you're a bridge. How do you see the current market growing?
Yeah. So, Sonia, so first of all, O2O is perceived in different perspectives. Because if you go and search for O2O, which started in 2010, so broadly, digital marketing was considered as the. One second, I think I'm hearing some echo. Yeah, so digital marketing was considered as the O2O mechanism where you are promoting yourself on digital medium and trying to bring the customers onto your shop. So that was that has a different perspective, but the commerce metrics are not given there. It was more on the impressions created. On the campaign. So you run a campaign and how many impressions got created and to whom you are showing that, first of all. So you see, if it is a generic campaign, whether you are interested or not, you are going and seeing it. But here we are bringing a localization concept wherein a particular user who is living in a location wants to see which seller is available for my need, or if I'm doing an apparel shopping, which local stores are running what offers. So that localization is there, because you simply go to the portal and set your filter, select your location as your location, and you're seeing all the offers, or you create an order and set that location that to which sellers you want to show this order. Because suppose I'm in Hyderabad and I'm in an area called Dilshuknagar, and I am only want to visit Dilshuknagar or surrounding couple of areas, there is no point in showing that order to a same seller who is in Banjaras, right? Because I am not interested to go there and buy. Then what is the point in showing this order to them? So that localization we are bringing in. So there's the way we have designed it is itself is based on the localization concept. So the commerce is happening here because the order is getting created only by the people who want to create or find out, do the inquiry. That means there is a commerce aspect. I know it is a half commerce, but still the commerce is there. Where unlike other platforms where you don't see that commerce angle, it's just based on the impressions only.
Right, and the market that we're catering is the unorganized majorly, which is almost 80% of retail today is unorganized. A lot of people who want to get into it, their main target has to be to club these people together. Right, yeah. if I'm not wrong, that being one. Yeah. My other question was, and while I think Gaurav did touch on that, still I need a little more clarity on that. We talked about how the geography is to be divided. So one is based on the demand. I say there's a certain retail places which are densely populated. There are more retail stores. And the other is based on the location. I say, you know, this pin code or these number of pin codes come under one person. How is that to be divided is my one question. And we talked about 1,000 people, retailers, sellers coming on board. How long does it take to bring these people on board? You know, what is the life cycle based? While you're still a startup, you just started off. But what, according to you, what is your experience the last few months? What I'm also reading is the last two odd months, there has been a bigger migration of these retailers coming on platform like yours because of problem with mobility and people not coming out. But what do you see the current trend, and how long will an individual take to bring these 1,000 people on board is one of my questions to you.
First question is how we are dividing the regions. So it is not pin code based, because pin code is not remembered by everyone. So we remember the area name. So we are going with the area names, we have divided the, we will be having 5 filters. One is category. Suppose electronics is the category, and under that we have subcategories like televisions or all other refrigerators, all of them coming under subcategory. Now, what is that you are purchasing? Because some electronic store might sell all the products, or some might sell only couple of subcategories of it. So the seller can choose based on the subcategory level also. Suppose you don't want to see the orders of refrigerator, you don't need to select the refrigerator so that you don't see those orders itself. And means we are minimal, it's all simplified manner. So per, and next other set of category of filter is the area, that's the area like city and the what are the areas under that city. Suppose if you take Hyderabad, there are 200 plus cities. So the 200 cities will be listed there, and you as a buyer, you have to decide what cities you know, what areas you know, because it's all buyer driven, Sonia. So buyer is the one who will select how or what, from where, from whom seller I want to see. This is how we have decided.
Okay, my other question again coming to that 1,000 number that you put. So that opportunity or that area should also have an opportunity to have at least 1,000 people and beyond. So, you know, so 1,000 comes from the filtered. So I say they are 10,000 out of 10,000 time able to onboard 1,000. So there has to be an opportunity in these geographies or whatever that areas to have at least 1,000 of these retailers coming on board. Okay. And the revenue that we talked about, 1 lakh is an annual revenue that one can take provided 1,000 sellers are trading on the platform.
No, it's monthly revenue.
It's monthly revenue. So you're assuming 1,000 are active retailers every month.
Yeah, because see, we are densely populated country, and you take any location, any metro city, we have 15 lakh, minimum 15 lakh retailers in a city like Hyderabad or Mumbai or something like that. So every area is highly populated, and you, in every day, you know, on a daily basis, somebody on, so you, as a partner, but your question is pointing towards the partner mode, then you should be smart enough to analyze what kind of sellers I will bring on this platform. Like you should have a synchronized, you should not only get only one category of sellers, so that you will get different kinds of some. On one day there will be a huge demand for one category, the other day some other category will make your business. So the need is, detail is so highly, highly dynamic. Lot of parameters drives in retail market. So every day is a new day, every hour is a new hour for retailers, be it buyers and sellers. So population is very high. Every region minimum, if suppose we are, let's take 1 year, we are taking time to communicate to people. And now everybody understood that there is a Minify available, and it simplifies my buying experience. Now, if you divide the population, easily like 10,000 to 20,000 will be available in one area. So out of that, you just need a couple of orders.
Right. So what we are saying is our speed of getting these retailers on board will define the returns an investor can have on the investment, while the investment is very low as far as, you know, from the initial deployment of money is concerned. But if he's able to bring these 1,000 people on board, he can have an ROI. By the time these people start trading, it can be as quick as, say, 3 months or even 6 months, depending on the speed of penetration.
So we did that. So to give you that answer, Sonia, so as soon as we launched in February, myself and Kiran wanted to get that first-hand experience of the sellers, and we visited sellers and onboarded around 100 sellers by ourselves. So, and on average, we could get 10 sellers in a day onboarded. So that was easy because...
10 sellers, how many would trade, Vikram, is also one of my questions. If you get 10 people on board, how many people out of these 10 would trade and do business? One, and is there a minimum coupon amount that one pays to get on board? So like you said, is there a 1,000 rupee coupon that he needs to buy to start selling?
No, we are giving welcome points. As I mentioned, it's a points based. They have to purchase points, but we are giving welcome points to them. Can you please mute? So we are giving welcome points to them so that they get accustomed to the product. About 150 points. That means up to 1 month to 3 months, they can utilize them. And if they are really liking it, they will try to recharge the points again and again. To your point, how, as I said, we'll just launch the product. And first, we need to get the minimum number of sellers onboarded. Then we'll communicate. We'll start the communication to buyers. So
I have another question. So the moment a retailer comes on board, he gets 150 complimentary points, right?
Yes. Yes.
And if he which he used to promote his even you said some promotional material flyer. If he wants to promote,
he can instantly launch his flyer.
Now, my also, if any transaction takes, so on these 150 points, the franchisee does not get anything because these are complimentary. He only gets points beyond 150. And that's where he makes his revenue on.
Yes, yes.
Okay. And how would you as a company help getting orders for a store? Because the role of a franchisee is to bring these people on board. Who does the work of getting people at the outlet? Any marketing by the company or the franchisee also involved in getting some footfall at the outlet?
Yeah, so as I said, if we have to work in conjunction, right? So they can have their team. They are having a team. So we will work with them because they are the field representatives who will be working. So we, and the back end, we will know what kind of sellers are getting onboarded. And through digital marketing, we can target, suppose, let's say in Hyderabad, 10 areas, we could get 25 sellers of mobile phone sellers got onboarded. Now we can start a digital campaign only to those 10 areas that, okay, don't step out, find the best quote from your local seller, create an order on this, something like that. So we already have in place, and we will target-based digital marketing we can kick off. That is one thing. And field representatives, we can utilize them to get orders, genuine orders created, and wait outside of the store. Somebody who is buying, and because they are the genuine buyers, they are in the need of the product. So you tell about our product platform to them and say, if somebody is interested, they will create it. And I did this exercise in February, and I was able to successfully get an order created, and even got a quotation to him from a couple of sellers as well.
What would you want as a partner? You know, because this requires a lot of tasks going to the retailers. What kind of profile of people do you think are the best would fit in an opportunity like this?
Yeah, see, initially once these processes are understood, initially they might need some time to be put in because the portal wants to get understanding of the product, the platform, the synergies, how the process are going, and what is that I need to communicate. To understand this, probably initial 3 months to 6 months, a person has to put in. But later on, he can just relax and wait, take the commission what he's getting for the next 3 years. Because once the seller is got used to it, so you're not digitating again and again until I am adding a new feature, and I want that communication to happen to that set of sellers, and I will rely on this channel. That I will educate only this partner and say that this is the benefit I am creating. This is a new feature I have added. And now please communicate with your 1,000 sellers. So that way I may use him as a single point of contact initially. Then if that person is having any trouble, they can contact our support team. And things can be sorted out.
My last question, you know, we talked about user experience and the entire platform, which is currently focused on users. My other question to you is also on the merchants or the retailers that come on board today. They also face a big challenge, and especially the unorganized ones. They also need some help from maybe platforms like you to generate and maybe leverage some kind of customer insights, because data is something which is very important even for the retailers. which can help them in understanding consumer behavior, their buying pattern, and maybe the accuracy of the impact that the online tools are making in order to improve their conversion rate. Is there anything that you're also offering to these merchants as a data point so that they can improve, they understand what is being purchased, what kind of demand, and why they're losing on the sales? So is something for the merchants too?
Yeah, it's too early to have the data created now. But we have in future, because it requires a lot of data. Only then you can work on data to create some insights. So, you know, even you want to put ML AI algorithms on it, you need that create data. So simply, I just want to put ML AI. I don't want to put now the ML AI algorithms and show some invalid insights to these guys, be it the seller or be it the partner. So now with the portal, they will have a simple information that what are the list of the sellers they have attached to, what business they are making, how much commission they are getting on a monthly basis. This is the initial information that these guys will be getting. What were the different set of category of sellers they belong to? So basic information which is needed for them to do the job, that is already, we are building that portal. But later on, once the data is created, then we'll analyze the insights, then we'll try to create that dashboards, reports to both the sellers, partners, and ourselves also. It might be a platform. Yeah.
Okay, I think we've kind of covered almost all questions, and there are some on the equity, which I think cannot be discussed at length on a platform like this. We can take that offline with people who have asked that. Are we looking at Pan-India at this stage? Are we looking at only South India to start off?
No. With? Yeah, it is open. Platform is already built for Pan-India. So it depends on who is coming and what level of it and how do we take it. So as I was mentioning it, so it depends on the budget. The entire budget, 70% needs for marketing only, this platform initially, at least for a couple of years. And once people know it and they are using it, I think it becomes like, okay, all the day-to-day, because it is single canvas for all product categories. So now it's like an OLX, like suppose you want to sell it, your used product, you think of OLX right now. People got used to it. So eventually that will happen, and we are hoping that it will happen. And this came out of our personal experience. So we did not create that, okay, I got an idea, I have not created it. So this idea was created, it came out from our personal experience. And when we understood that, okay, because we were working, we had our jobs. So we understood that this is a day-to-day problem for everyone in the lives. Because there are every product category, some or the other will spend a lot of time, wait for a weekend to do their shopping and identify the shop. So this is the only way, one of the ways to minimize the effort. Currently, no other platform is giving the exact solution. There are bits and pieces, static information is provided.
Okay, I have a question because I see some people asking, is there any competition? People are talking about OLX, are they offering something similar? There's something like Fatafat, I don't know what it is, but they're saying, is it something like Fatafat? But I know there are two other brands in the O2O space, like Shopmatic is one, and Kootloots is another brand. Any similarities in terms of what you do and how you differentiate yourself from maybe platforms which are similar or maybe competition, any of any sorts?
Yeah, we have seen the portals, Kootloots we have seen. And I'm Shopmatic, I've heard. I didn't got into details of it. But yeah, as I mentioned, the main problem they are not addressing for a seller. They are asking them to showcase the products. All of them, which is a very tedious process for every retailer. So you go to them and ask to publish their products on the list. They'll say, sir, I'm sorry, bye-bye. Because we have done that research. Even before modeling the product, we went and spoke to around some 10-20 odd sellers and asked them why we are not on e-commerce portals. When you are able to reach to customers from across India sitting in some corner of Hyderabad, now Amazon or Flipkart is giving an option for you to sell to across India, then why are you not doing that? That means the only answer was, even when we are going, and as I said, I mentioned, we did 100 odd sellers onboarded on our platform by ourselves. First question was, do I have to list my products in this platform? That was the first question 80% of the sellers asked us. As the moment we said no need, it was very easy for us to convince to get onboarded on this onto this platform. So because we identified that pain point, so that's why it is easy for these sellers to get onboarded.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
So we can take a last closing remarks from everybody, and starting with you, Vikram, Kiran, You've been very quiet, so you should really start, rather.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. So thanks, Gaurav, for giving this opportunity. So we want this platform to become like an offline Google for everyone. Okay, whatever you want to purchase, you just create an order, wait for a few hours. I mean, once the traction gets created, earlier, like, let's take the example of Paytm. See, when Paytm came, not everybody were using it for transactions and everything. But once the, demonetization was there, now when we check, even a banana seller, has the Paytm code on his, the vehicle or whatever that he takes, like that. Now, this becomes an offline Google wherein whatever you want to purchase, sometimes you visit your relative's place, you really like the sofa over there, but you don't know where to purchase because it's not a branded one. Your wife liked some hardware, which by visiting some other place, just take the photograph of it and upload it on the Minify app, and you just select the area. If you don't know that it is, if it's not available in this particular area, we request them to select the entire city. Say, for example, if it's a sofa, you're spending 50 to 60,000, all right? You're ready to go to little faraway places as well. So, and select the entire city. All the sellers will be able to see your orders. They'll just send their quotes, and you'll be able to find the exact same piece, whatever you wanted. See, now, if in that case, it is really tough nowadays to find what exactly you want. Sometimes what happens, you visit one or two stores, you'll not find that, and you'll compromise on whatever is available. But once this platform is there, you don't need to compromise. You just wait for a day, and you know where exactly it is available, and you know how much it is available and what's the exact price. When we were talking about real estate earlier, sometimes you go to an area, he is telling you an approximate price, and that's the price of the builder. But when you create an order on this platform, you'll get to know what is the exact average that is going on in that area. So you can decide based on that. So that's the way this platform will really make it easy for the customers to get the prices and information, whatever they want, at on their fingertips. Even for the sellers, now we are talking about the advertising their products and everything. If the sellers are advertising it over the platform, it's not costing anything less than 1,000 or 2,000, even if they are going for a classified in the paper. But whereas we are giving a platform wherein they can advertise their product per day, it's costing around only 5 rupees, Gaurav. So even if they are spending for advertisements in a month, 200 or 300 rupees, they'll be able to advertise their product, and the scope of the customers will drastically improve wherever the customer is. If he's ready to buy in that area, he'll be able to see your advertisement. Even if you want to put a small banner in front of your shop, that will not cost you anything less than 500, and only those who go around over there will be able to see that banner. But if you're putting it in the platform, for the entire month, it is costing you 200, 300, and the reach is you will be able to publish it across India. If the customer is selecting your area, he'll be able to see the order. See the advertisement. So that's what, it's like a win-win situation for both of them, Gaurav, even for the customer as well as seller also. But as it's a platform, it's an app, it may take some time, but once it flies, it will spread across India very easily.
Thank you, Kiran. I think you have a point. Any quick thing, because we already run out of time, so any quick thing from you, Sonia, Vikram?
Yeah, I like the way Kiran used local Google, so I will leave you with that for now. So I think I have spoken enough and I've communicated the entire point. So that's all from my side, and thanks to both of you, and thanks to the Franchise India Group for having us and letting us know to talk about our product to a wider audience, and hopefully we'll be able to see some traction from there.
So thank you so much, Kiran, Vikram, for a detailed explanation of the model. I would say our current times have really heightened the a requirement of a lot of these offline retailers to come online, and they need to perhaps work on their digital abilities, and players like you will help us and them doing that, and wish you all the best.
Thanks.
And my last 2-cent advice to you would be that in every startup I give, that you are in the very delicate situation where you have a disruption in your mind what you want to create.
Yeah.
Inside, you also are inviting a lot of investors who would also have aspirations of their entire thing. So create very careful partnerships. This is very important for the early stage startups to demonstrate shareholder value, initial investors to get their performance. Take your micro market, maybe Hyderabad itself. Create a big success story there and then go out and do this entire thing. Create like-minded partners who can come and invest with you in the early stage, and you'll be very successful. And I always have encouraged brilliant ideas, and more than important, entrepreneurs are founders who have desire to bring some change. So while businesses have risk and they have opportunities, but at Franchise India, we strongly believe that we'll continue to promote founders like you who have desire of change or bringing something new to the world. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Sure. Thanks.
Thank you, Gaurav and Sonia.
Thank you. Thank you, Vikram. Thank you, Kirit.
Archana, over to you for a quick thanks.
Thank you so much, Gaurav sir. So we really appreciate the effort and time put in by everyone, by our attendees, our participants, our brand of the day, Vikram and Kiran, by Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am for this particular session. Participants and friends, we request you, please do reach to us through your calls and emails. The information is already there in the chat tool. Follow us on all our social network. You can also reach out to Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am through their LinkedIn profile. As a team, we'll definitely love to give you answer for all your queries. Will help you, happy to help each one of you. With this information, we'll give you the information about tomorrow's webinar. Again, a great brand. And we have a founder and CEO of Uclean, Arnab Sinha, who is launching this new product. It's a low-cost opportunity, business opportunity for each one of you. Do not miss this particular chance. Meet Laundry Man of India sharp tomorrow, 11th June at 12 o'clock. Look forward to have each one of you for this particular great session. Do take good care of yourself, your families, and your friends. Best wishes for the day. Thank you so much.